हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेशन। वी विल डिस्कस इंडियन पॉलिटिकल थॉट एंड वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस पंडिता रमाबाई। फ्रेंड्स, पंडिता रमाबाई वॉज एन एक्सेप्शनल वूमेन ऑफ मॉडर्न इंडिया, वी कैन से। हर लाइफ स्पैन स्ट्रेच्ड फ्रॉम 1858 टू 1922, द पीरियड इन विच इंडिया वॉज ऑलरेडी स्ट्रगलिंग विद मैनी ऑफ द प्रॉब्लम्स ऑफ इट्स टाइम्स, एंड द कास्टिज्म, द पेट्रियार्की, द जेंडर इशूज, They were the major problems. And her critique of the patriarchy and demand for civil rights and gender justice reflects her political thoughts about the Indian society. She outspoken and champions the women's right and social reforms issues at that time in India, and earned a very distinctive, we can say characteristic, and a very distinction image in the society. Okay, so we can say that Ramabai was born to Anant Shastri, and she was a Brahman by her caste. And as I already told you, she was born in 1858, and as a child she lived the life of a Brahman, the typical Brahman pilgrim, and traveled the Indian subcontinent with her parents and two siblings. Okay, and her father actually provide him the knowledge about the Puranas, the Vedas, the Shastras. That is why she actually earned that knowledge at a very young age. And she also used to learn with the Brahmin boys and to teach Sanskrit at a very, very young age. That is why she earned that Pandita, actually we can say the title Pandita she earned because of that. And we can say the specially remarkable, considering the fact that at that time women were even denied to have the primary education. At that time Pandita Ramabai got such a higher education, and she was actually unconventional. Her upbringing was unconventional. That is why she was able to think about the problems of gender, the problem of caste, the problem of patriarchy, which were prevalent in the Indian society at that time. So what were the issues she tried to handle? Contesting patriarchy, Hinduism and Christianity. So what were those? Ramabai founded the Arya Mahila Sabha in 1881. That is very important for you to understand. And this may be termed as the first feminist organization of India. This was the first feminist organization totally devoted to the issues of the females in India. However, she entered the feminist discourse of those time through her first book, and the name of the book was Dharma Niti, Stri Dharma Niti, and which actually literally means in English the morals of women. So these were some things by which Pandita Ramabai tried to solve the problems of patriarchy, which was prevalent in Hindu society. And it is not pertinent that it was, it is not, we can say, it is not, it was not actually only in the Hinduism. The problem of patriarchy is a very well known issue, and it is prevalent in all the religions. So like women rules did not permit the Shudras to perform the same religious acts as the upper caste. Actually, this was a practice in the Indian society, that the lower caste people, the Shudras or other castes, were not able to perform the religious thing, the worships in the temples, such as the women in the upper caste. The women which used to belong to the upper caste, they were actually equivalent to those of the lower caste. So Ramabai rejected this discrimination in her personal life, and she decided to accept a marriage proposal from Bipin Bihari. And he was actually a Shudra, thereby decisively breaking with tradition. This was the outbreak, and she was actually, we can say, outcast from her community. Vipin was excommunicated, as it was an intercaste marriage by civil registration. Just after 2 years of marriage, Vipin's death, she got widowed, and she was very young. She was of 24 at that time. So we can say Pandita Ramabai faced a lot of problem in her very early age, and the lessons which she learned from her young age tried to solve those issues through whole of her life. रमाबाई ऑल्सो गॉट एक्वेंटेड विद द फेमिनिस्ट एंड अदर रिफॉर्मिस्ट सर्किल इन फिलाडेल्फिया एंड बॉस्टन. शी सून कॉन्टेक्टेड वेरियस चर्च ग्रुप्स एंड वीमेन्स वेलफेयर ग्रुप्स इन अ फंड रेजिंग कैंपेन फॉर हर लॉन्ग लिव ड्रीम ऑफ वुमेन्स होम इन इंडिया. दिस वॉज हर ड्रीम. America clearly inspired her with notions of freedom and liberty. As you know, America achieved its freedom in 1776, and the Bill of Rights, actually we can say just like the preamble of our constitution. Americans have a very small constitution, and actually it is the Bill of Rights in which the rights of the people are provided. So that influenced a lot to Ramabai. She published The High Caste Hindu Woman. With the name The High Caste Hindu Woman, India's first feminist manifesto. It is very important. You should underline that. The name was The High Caste Hindu Woman, and it was India's first feminist manifesto with an agenda, we can say, for women's emancipation and empowerment. Then she returned back to India. She returned to Maharashtra. Ramabai experienced her first public encounter with the forces of patriarchy. She used to live in America. The Americans actually got, we can say, evolved with that problem, but the problem was still persistent in India. She also used to face that problem, and as I already told you, she found the Arya Mahila Samaj in 1882 to mobilize the women to make them aware of their rights. And I also told you that she brought out a book in Marathi, Stri Dharma Niti, The Morals of the Women. Okay. So these were some outstanding work of Ramabai, we can say. And this was the work of she got in the feminist discourse and to challenge the system of patriarchy which was prevalent in Indian society. Now comes the critique to patriarchy. The reform movements of those time focused on the caste and gender issues. So as I already told you, Ramabai was one of the feminist leaders. She was among the very few social reformers of India, and we can say the very first reformer who actually tried to put this issue on the front table so that it came into consideration. Okay. And the same was persistent in all the religions. This is very important for you to understand that Ramabai also changed her religion at the later stage of her life. But she faced that this problem of patriarchy persists in all the religions. So the problem can be solved when the women themselves try to put their issues on the front desk. And those can be considered by the people who are in command. Okay. Ramabai also. This is the verbatim of one of the discussions she had. Ramabai encounters the patriarchy with Anglican church across the globe was no less harsh, as I told you. When she was offered a professorship which would involve her teaching to male students, the Bishop of Bombay protested. Or above all things, pray believe that her influence will be ruined forever in India if she is known to have taught young men. When this happened, Ramabai replied that, "It surprises me very much to think that neither my father nor my husband objected my mother's or my teaching young men while some young people are doing so." When she was of little age, her father, and when she was young, her husband supported her. But what was astonishing for her is that young men who are supposed to be developed, who are supposed to be matured in their thinking, actually they were, we can say, objecting her motive. So Ramabai's life is very much to consider, and considering the time period in which her life span got stretched from 1858 to 1922, this was the hodgepodge time period for India. Also, the first freedom movement in 1857 occurred. Then after the objection of the British Raj, the harshness of the British Raj also increased in India. Then the advent of Gandhi, then whole that Congress political things. But among all these things, some issues, some social reformist issue like gender issues, caste issues, and the issues of patriarchy were prevalent. And there were social reformers who actually tried to solve those problems, because these issues were also related to the independence of India. Ultimately, they play their role, and Ramabai was one of them. That is why we are studying Ramabai. She was, as I told you, she was a Christian convert and renowned social reformer. Pandita Ramabai was a scholar of Hindu who had profound disagreement with its philosophical premises. Whatever Ramabai learned in her young age, she actually protests that. Okay, she actually provide his disagreement to that. And when at her later stage she turned into a Christian, then she felt that those problems are actually found in all the religions. Okay, so this was the lecture about Ramabai. Now some of the important questions which we can discuss. Ramabai, being a Sanskrit scholar, was unable to connect with the lower classes of the masses at her time to an optimum extent because her image was an obstacle. Ramabai, being a very learned woman, and even after her objection towards whatever she learned at her young age, but she was not able to connect with the masses. She was not able to connect with the people actually whose problem she was trying to solve, because her image of upper class Brahmanical lady was actually an obstacle. So this was a very, very, we can say, big problem for the Ramabai herself. But she grew up after that and she actually cover up that. Okay. Second question being, which Indian social reformer considered the patriarchy among all the religions and caste system is considered as a major problem in the society? In this particular question, it may be possible you may be provided some objective type answers. Then you have to find out that Ramabai was one of the very few scholars and actually was the first feminist scholar who found out that patriarchy is the problem in all the religions, in all the castes. It has nothing to do with the Hinduism or Islam or Christianity or the upper classes in Hinduism or the lower classes. It is persistent in all the religions and castes. Okay, so Ramabai is the answer. So that's all for the lecture, friends.